Good morning, grade 7 student. Last time, we talked about noun and the simple verb. For today's lesson, we're going to talk about the subject-verb agreement. Before we proceed with our discussion, I want you to review your previous lesson to have a better understanding about the new lesson. Because nouns and verbs has a big contribution with the lesson we're going to tackle about. If you are ready, let's get started.
In this video, we will learn the basics of subject-verb agreement. Before understanding subject-verb agreement, we will understand what is subject and verb in the sentence and how to identify subject and verb in any sentence. Then we will understand what exactly is subject-verb agreement and basic rule surrounding it. So without a further go, let's get started. So what is a subject in the sentence? The subject of a sentence is the person, place, thing, or idea that is doing or being something. And what is a verb in the sentence? It is the action performed by the subject or state of being. Let's understand it with an example. Ajay plays cricket regularly. Now, to identify the subject, ask here who is performing the action of playing. It is Ajay. So, Ajay is the subject here. And to identify the verb, ask the question what subject is performing. It is playing. So, it is the verb in this case. This way, we can identify the subject and verb in the sentence asking these questions. Now, based on point of view, subject may be in first person, second person, or third person. In first person, we have I and we. In second person, we have you. And in third person, we have he, she, it, they. And based on count, subject may be singular or plural. These all things we have discussed in detail in our Parts of Speech video series. I will provide you the link in the description in case you need it. Please go through those videos, you will get the revision. Now, let's understand the main topic of today. What is subject-verb agreement? For making a sentence grammatically correct, a verb must agree with its subject in number. That is to say, in any sentence, singular subject must have singular verb and plural subject must have plural verb. This is the most general rule, so again I will repeat. Singular subject must have singular verb and plural subject must have plural verb. Please note, this statement holds true only when subject is in third person. Now, let's look into examples to make things clear. Let's look into example where subject is singular. That monkey eats banana. Here, subject is monkey, which is singular. So, verb will also be singular. In this case, it is eats. Let's look into one more example. This car goes fast. Here, the subject is car, which is singular. Verb will also be singular. In this case, it is goes. Now, let's look into same examples where subject is plural. Those monkeys eat bananas. Here, subject is monkeys, which is plural in form. So, verb will also be plural in form. So, in this case, we used eat. Let's look into the next example. These cars go fast. Here, the subject is cars, which is plural in form. So, verb will also be in plural form. So, please remember this rule. Now, let me give you an example of it. She writes every day. Here, she is singular. So, singular verb writes is used. Now, let's look into an example where the plural noun is used. They write every day. Here, they is plural. So, the plural verb write is used. This is the most general rule. So, please remember this rule. Then, we learned 6 rules of subject-verb agreement in our previous video. Let me quickly give a recap of those six rules. Rule number one, two singular subjects connected by AND require a plural verb. Rule number two, two or more singular subjects joined by or nor require a singular verb. Rule number three, when the subjects joined by or nor are of different persons, the verb agrees with the nearer one. Rule number four, words like either, neither, each, everyone, may must be followed by a singular verb. Rule number five, some noun which is plural in form but singular in meaning takes a singular verb. Rule number one, use of collective noun in a sentence. How the subject verb agreement works when a collective noun is used. Before that, let's understand what is a collective noun. A collective noun is a name for a group of people or things such as family, class, pack, pair, and flock. Collective nouns generally take a singular verb because they are singular. Let's look into the examples to make things clear. The family is driving across the country this summer. Here, all the members of the family are driving across the country. So we have used singular verb is. Let's look into one more example of this kind. The couple eats out once a month. Here we are talking about both husband and wife are going together. So we have used singular verb eats. But there are exceptions to this rule. We use a plural verb when the members of the group are acting as individuals. For example, the family are each doing a different task. Here, as per the sentence, we can understand that all the members in the family are not up to the same task. As they are not working as a singular unit, we have used the plural verb are here. Let's look into one more example of this kind. The couple are taking separate cars to work today. Here, in this sentence, we can understand that both husband and wife are not going in the same car. Instead, they both are taking a separate car. As they are not working as a single entity here, we have used the plural verb are. This is rule number one. In case of collective noun in the sentence, use a singular verb when the member of the group are acting as single unit and plural verb when the members of the group are not acting as a single unit. Rule number five, use of here or there in the sentence. In sentences beginning with here or there, we use the general rule. A singular verb is used when the singular subject is there in the sentence and plural verb is used when the plural subject is there in the sentence. For example, there are four hurdles to jump. Here, for plural subject hurdles, we have used the verb are. Let's look into another example. There is a high hurdle to jump. Here, for the singular subject hurdle, we used singular verb is. Let's look into one more example of this kind. Here are the keys. Here, for the plural subject keys, we use the plural verb are. So, this is rule number 5. In a sentence beginning with here or there, the singular verb is used when the singular subject is there in the sentence and a plural verb is used when the plural subject is there in the sentence. Let's look into the next rule. Rule number 6. Use of distances, periods of time, sums of money in a sentence. We use a singular verb with distances, periods of time, sums of money, etc. when considered as a unit. For example, 3 miles is too far to walk. Here we have used a singular verb is as the distance. 3 miles is used as a single unit. Let's look into one more example. 5 years is the maximum sentence for that offense. Here we have used a singular verb is as 5 years is considered as a single unit. There is an exception to this rule. When the subject is not considered as a single unit, we use a plural verb. For example, $10 were scattered on the floor. Here, we have used plural verb were. You can notice that. So this is rule number 6. Use a singular verb with distances, period of times, sums of money, etc. when considered as a single unit. Rule number 8. Use of each or every in the sentence. Two nouns qualified by each or every even though connected by AND, require a singular verb. For example, every boy and every girl was given a packet of sweets. Here, we have used a singular verb was as the word every is used in the sentence. Let's look into one more example of this kind. Every man and every woman is kind in that family. Here, we have used is because the word every is used in the sentence. So this is rule number 8. Two nouns qualified by each or every, even though connected by AND, require a singular verb. Rule number 10. Use of words where suffix is body, thing, one in the sentence. The words of this kind are somebody, everybody, anybody, nobody, everything, something, anything, nothing, everyone, someone, anyone, no one. These words will carry a singular verb. For example, someone has stolen my bag. Here, we have used a singular verb has because someone is used. Let's look into one more example of this kind. Something is better than nothing. We have used the singular verb is because something is used here. This is rule number 10. Words with suffix body, thing, one will carry a singular verb.
We made it! We're done! I hope you grasped everything about the video. Now, you can proceed to your second module for your sit work and quiz. Good luck!